Just a little quick video. Just gonna let you guys know that I actually went out yesterday for a fish, first time in a long time, but messed up big time. And this video is just basically going to be just a tip on what not to do. Don't do what I done yesterday and cost yourself some fish and a lot of fuel. A lot of you guys will know this, but a lot of guys won't. And as you know, this time of year, it's summertime. The little blacks are here. There's dolphin fish on the fads. Okay, it's a great time of year to go trawling. And even fishing fads, throwing bait stuff at dolphin fish. It's just a good fun time of year. And yesterday, I took a couple of good friends out. We were going to go, we went for a trawl. We started off in the south. Left the seaway. I knew there's a few little blacks up at the pin, so we run up there, we put the lures in. Pretty much in the first couple of minutes, we got a strike, lost that fish. I'm pretty sure it was a little black, it was in dirty green water. And then nothing, it went really quiet, so we went out wide. Started trolling out, we got to the 36 Northeast Fad, had a look around at. See any dolphin fish, anyone catching. Continued trawling out to the Northeast 50s, to the fad out there. A couple of boats on it, got to it. Lots of dolphin fish on it, a few boats on it, few boats cleaning up, catching a lot of fish. You can see one after the other. And they weren't small fish yesterday, which is good to see. Some of the fish we saw go past the boat were actually monsters. A lot of them like medium-sized fish, like 6 to 8 kilo sort of fish. They're nice fish, not big fish, but nice fish, not those little tiny rats. A couple of boats were catching a lot. A few boats were catching absolutely nothing. So we decided just to troll around it for a little while on the outside, see if we can hook some of those big ones. They didn't eat lures. And we had a few pillies and stuff on board, so we thought, well, I'll float down some pillies past the fads or drifting around the fad. And we tried that for a couple of hours and didn't even get a bite. Fish were everywhere, just under the boat. You can see them jumping. We even see bait. You even saw them push the little bait schools up to the surface yesterday, and the big ones going through the bait schools. And we couldn't get a touch. I even rigged up a garfish. I had a garfish and swam a garfish. I had a swimming garfish. We'd done a few laps of that. Didn't touch it, which is surprising. But I did keep a close eye on the boats that were catching fish, and this is where I messed up, because in the morning I should have stopped and done this, but I didn't, and it cost us a lot of fuel and no fish yesterday. So guys, very important tip. This time of year, before you head out wide, I don't care if you're going trolling or going to the fads, straight to the fads or what you're doing, but 9 times out of 10, when we're out wide, most of us stop. Out of course, if there's a fad in the area, we'll go past just to see if there's fish on it and have a fish. So here we go. Don't do what I done yesterday. So two boats that were catching fish, a lot of fish, and well, so I'm gonna say medium size to large, but not the extra large. The extra large, I don't think anyone caught yesterday. But mediums to large, so say 6 to 10 kilos sort of fish. They were using live baits. Those fish yesterday were hitting live baits. The two boats that had live baits cleaned up. Myself and a couple of other boats, we tried all sorts of lures, we tried all sorts of baits, pilchards. Like I said, I even rigged up a garfish and swam a garfish, like a proper swimming garfish. Didn't get touched. So we decided to trawl all the way home. That was a very long day trawling. As you can see, I'm nice and burnt. Wasted a lot of fuel. My two friends didn't take any fish home. It was a bit of a bugger of a day. Point being, guys, if you're planning on chasing dolphin fish or anything, or going to fads or out, if you are or not, just stop at the bait ground, grab some bait before you head out. Trust me, it might just save the trip. That's a lesson I learned yesterday. I should have known better. I actually said to my friend, we're going to get some bait the night before. But when I left the seaway, it was nice and calm. I was in a hurry to get to the pin and start trawling. I didn't even worry about bait, and it bit me in the backside. Just one of those things, guys. It's fishing. It happens. I'm just letting you know, this time of year, get some live bait before you go out. That might just save the trip. Anyway, we'll see what happens next week. If next week's weather's all right, we're going to head back out, but I'm going to get some bait first. And by the way, saying this, live bait doesn't always work. They are fads. The fish do shut off at times. They won't eat anything at times. But it's always nice to have a few livies on board, because if they're a bit finicky and they're not eating pilchards or lures or something, they generally will eat a live bait. So it's just nice to have them there. And even if you don't use them on the fads, guys, and you're out in the 50s or something, float them down. You might catch a kingfish or a snapper or something. You just never know. It might just save the trip. Anyway, that's my sob story for this week. we'll see what happens next week. But next week, we'll definitely take bait. We'll see what happens. Go try again, eh? See you guys.
Show the boats back at home and see what they're trawling through.